In the forecast fragment, we want to modify the fetch weather task so that we can pass in the postal code parameter when we execute that task. You can click on this class to jump to where it's defined, or you can use this shortcut. And here you see that we modified the generic input type to be a string so that the doInBackground method receives string params. Now we only passed in one string param, 94043. So when you see down here later, we can read out the zeroth position in the params array to get that postal code. Notice that we're using the URI builder here and we're appending query parameters one by one. We define constants for these query params as seen here. And for the values, we also define them up here. You can imagine that in the future, these might be configured outside of this class, but for now, we're just going to define them here. To verify that this URI was built up properly, we add a verbose log command to print out the built URI. Let's verify that the log we added actually shows up. In the overflow menu, we tap refresh. Then we see the log tag fetchWeatherTask with our URI printed out. It says 94043, JSON format, metric units, 7 days. So this looks correct.